when I go into.
Imagine yourself without all those self-doubts, and you know your self-worth. Would you be here now? You know, when you're in the situation, you start doubting yourself and telling yourself you can't do this, and you start, you know, focusing on things that don't really matter. That's when you start going down the wrong path. It's that mental block that people run into where they don't get to those goals. Let me show you what happens when you finally take that leap of faith for yourself. Thinking that they've won, it's only just begun.
Checking in, athlete check-in, and then checking into a different hotel, the athlete's hotel closer to the convention center. And then I'll be doing my last workout at the Powerhouse Gym of Columbus, which is a big spot for a lot of people coming to the Arnold. That should be fun. And then I'm relaxing for the rest of the day in the other hotel. So get through today, carving up tomorrow, have some fun. So here we go.
Okay guys, just to give you a little info on how I got my meals down here through the airport. So I'm gonna give full credit to Lindsay on this one. She helped me out a lot. So I packed everything in my six pack bag, and this was used as my, actually it was used as my personal item. So I wasn't charged for it. It fit underneath the seat. So what I did is I hard boiled all my egg whites and separated them into Ziploc bags. And so for starting out for ice packs, I actually used sweet peas, frozen peas, because you can't use the ice packs that they have, the liquid ice packs. So I also have all my rice separated, measured out into Ziploc bags. I froze all my meat, so all of my fish meals are frozen. And they're actually used, they could be used as ice packs too. So I have all them separated into my meals individually. And the last thing I had frozen were my waffles for Thursday. So I had all this thrown in here. Like I said, the peas were used as rice packs. And so since today is Wednesday and I have no carbs, what I did is I took all my meals for today, put them in the fridge last night so they can thaw. You know, all of my fish is thawed. Egg whites, that's a bag of spinach that's being thawed out. So it's all ready to go today. So in the side pockets here, I have shakes, shake meals, in case I need those. And then in my other side, I have my almonds down here. So the amount of meals that this fit was, let's see, one last night when I landed, and then I have egg whites, three fish meals today, and another egg white meal, and then I have three meals packed for tomorrow. So essentially nine meals, if I'm doing the math correctly. So nine meals fit into here. So yeah, that's how I did it. And no questions were asked from TSA and we made it. So so I'm checked into the hotel. I'm not gonna go too much into my room, but I did want to show you guys the fitness center that we have here at the Sheraton. Pretty legit. I mean, there's a couple machines, treadmill over here, some dumbbells. Pretty nice. And decent amount of cardio machines. The cool thing is, you come over here to the treadmills, the cardio machines, you have a pretty nice overlook of the city. And here in a minute I'm going to try to make it down to the powerhouse, which is going to be right down there. So I'm going to get my last workout in of prep, and it's going to be arms and back. So I might take a nap now because I am exhausted, because I just walked from the convention center way over there all the way to here to the hotel. So here I am with the legit fitness center. I do have cardio tomorrow morning, so I'll be able to use some of these cardio machines, but I just came up here to fill up my water bottle. All right, guys. All right, guys, it's Thursday morning, and I have stuff on my face because I just woke up, but it's Thursday morning, and it is currently 6 o'clock. No alarm clock. I just kind of woke up because I can't really sleep in. I couldn't get much sleep last night because my anxiety is kind of going through the roof right now. I'm getting excited about the show. But anyway, I have 45 minutes of some steady state cardio to do. So I'm going to go up to that fancy little fitness center and do that. And then I'm going to come back, and I'm waiting on Josh to reply on whether or not I'm gonna start carbs this morning or not. So you guys will find out in a second. But last night I was laying in bed, and this happens a lot to me. I kind of hype myself up to make hype videos. So I have all these like speeches that kind of arise in my head, and it's like I imagine myself like making these motivational videos for you guys, just like me coming up with these little speeches. And what happens is I end up laying in bed, and like it takes like 2 hours, and then I come to here to make the video, and it just kind of goes off and like turns into a bunch of jumble. So here goes nothing. So
A lot of you guys, well, not a lot of you guys, but I've had some people reach out to me saying that they find what I do motivational, and it baffles me because I know all the stuff that I go through and I fail. You know, I'm not perfect. Yeah, I fail more so than what you guys realize. But the thing is I feel like what motivates people is the fact that I keep going. You know, it's not like I fail, I get knocked down, and I'm down for like months. But don't get me wrong, that's happened before. But recently, I've been doing a lot of different, a lot of new things, and a lot of new adventures have been coming my way, and it's been very hard for me to keep going. But one thing that has really gotten me through this prep was the fact that I wasn't doing it alone. I've had help from a lot of people, and you know, sitting back and when I'm on the brink of failure, I remember those people who have helped me, and it makes me realize that I can't let those people down. So I want to thank everybody who's helped me thus far and who is going to continue to help me, because some people are still going to help me in these next 2 days, day and a half, whatever. But don't get me wrong, I have failed. And it's not the fact that it's not the fact that I'm here now, it's the fact that I have gotten back up when I have fallen. So for those of you who think that I make these videos to and I make the posts and I do all this stuff just for attention, you completely have it wrong. My whole goal with WorkHorse for a long time now has been just to be able to motivate at least one person. And if I can go to bed knowing that I have motivated at least one person in any form of their life, whether it's fitness or health related or career related or whatever, that's been my whole goal, not only with WorkHorse, but like in everything that I do. So it's, I always go back to thinking, you know, if you are this big motivational person, you have people watching you, and you want them to find motivation in everything you do. So when I fall, I think about that, and it gets me back up. And through this prep, it's really helped me. So I just wanted to once again thank everybody who's helped me this far. And you know, this is just a smidgen of the little motivational speech that I came up with last night. So I might be throwing in some more little things throughout this video, throughout the weekend. So I'll have to do cardio and maybe carbs. Alright guys, it's Friday, and we made it to show day, and I'm tan now. So, a little update on what's been going on. Obviously, I got my tan done. We had our athletes meeting this morning at 7:30, but Lindsay and I have been running around trying to get my posing CD figured out. We ran into a little problem, so we've been rushing around, and we got it all figured out with like 7 minutes to spare. So everything is good to go. I am 2 meals in, and it is 8:30 right now. Going backstage at 10, and yeah, then it's showtime. So I will talk to you guys after the show.
So I ended up placing top 15, which you know, obviously you want to win or place top five or make finals or whatever, but I was overall pleased with the whole weekend. And, you know, I'm happy that I can now cross off the bucket list that I competed at the Arnold Amateur. Is it the last time I'm going to do it? Probably not. Is it the next show that I'm going to do? Is that the next show that I'm going to do? Who knows? I don't really have a plan for a show. But I do know that I know what I need to work on, and it's going to be fixed for the next show. And I am more than excited to get going and put my foot forward on the gas pedal and keep moving forward. You know, those last couple days of a vacation where everything seems to fly by and it goes by so quickly. Well, that's kind of how it happened as soon as I stepped off stage. It was really fun getting to step on stage with those amazing competitors, and my class had actually all of Classic Physique had some really good competitors. So I was overall I was happy to get to meet those people, and I was overall pleased with everything. So as soon as I stepped off stage, my parents were there, they made it up, and my brother Darian. I was happy to see them because now I live 15 hours away from them, so that was very exciting for me. I actually took them to the expo, took them to the Redcon booth, and they got to try the MRE bars and the Breakfast at the Ready bars, which they loved, and that was fun. My mom had all kinds of fun trying all the samples at all the different booths. It was a really good time. So after that, we actually went to the Cheesecake Factory, which I know everybody loves the Cheesecake Factory. I have the new Cinnabon cheesecake, which is really good. If you like Cinnabon and cheesecake, just put those two together and it's even better. So that was really good. And then Lindsay and I went to Buckeyes Donuts in downtown Columbus. If you guys ever get the chance and you like donuts and you're Columbus, try those out. They're really good. Let's see, what else did we do? Sunday, we ended up going back to the expo and hung out with Davey Freeman and his fiance, Lauren, and that was really fun. Davey's like a brother to me. And they had a good time too, so I was glad I got to see them. And we actually ended up going back to the Cheesecake Factory, which, if you know me or Lindsay, you know that's not out of the question whenever either of us are in Columbus or Louisville. When we were in Louisville one year, we actually went to the Cheesecake Factory 3 times in the same weekend. So, needless to say, we like cheesecake. But you know, it was a really exciting experience for me to compete with those elite athletes. You know, the Arnold Amateur does have elite athletes, whether you believe so or not. And it was very fun to get to meet those people and step on stage. And, you know, it's very thrilling and motivating to be a part of the whole process. So, you know, here I am back in Florida. I know what I need to work on. And I don't have a show set in mind, so don't ask me about what show I'm doing because I don't know yet. But I do know what I need to fix, and it's going to be fixed. So I'm ready to put my foot on the gas pedal. I've had my fun with the food, and now it's time to get better and time to make a difference. So on to the next chapter.